tuning in to 2K Sports for the latest presentation of our NBA basketball. This is Kevin Harlan along with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. And of course, David Aldridge is joining us tonight from the sideline. Let's see some of the numbers here for Kevin Love.
And guys, I think the best way to measure his performance these last 10 games is his effective field goal percentage, which has improved, a sign that his game is in much better shape than it was not too long ago.
And with pregame routines coming to an end, we're just about ready for our tip-off. First, though, let's get a report from the sideline and say hello to David Aldridge.
Kevin, thank you. Chris Middleton has been underrated for so long that now is he rated? Giannis Antetokounmpo said people don't know how much Chris has sacrificed for this team to be great. He could easily be a 25-point-per-game scorer in the league, but he just wants to win. He knows that by doing that, everything else is going to take care of itself. Kevin?
Well, he's an all-star teammate, David, as you point out in that story. Thank you. Clark, for both teams tonight, unbelievable talent up front.
Kevin, you're right. I love seeing what we have in store in the paint area in this matchup. I think that's likely where this game is going to be decided.
Here are the starters for Milwaukee. And forward, they have Middleton and Giannis. Holiday out there with Allen, and it's Portis in at center. And for the Cavaliers, Mobley and Allen, the two big men inside. Then it's Lauri Markkanen. Then there's Garland, and it's Stevens in a two-guard. So the Bucks win the tip. Allen surveying the D. Middleton outside. Giannis high post. It's deflected. Markkanen into the lane. Here's Mobley. Banked in off the glass. Mobley's got the first points up on the board for the Cavs.
And Markkanen, the big fella, has nice court vision. Solid at finding open teammates.
Garland against Holiday. Shoots over Garland. The shot by Holiday, no good. Right side, Garland. Allen, and it's Allen slamming it down.
Boy, exhibiting toughness right there and persistence. Allen might have been fouled on that inside basket.
About 1 minute into the first quarter. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need the basket.
Antetokounmpo, no good.
And typically, he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
One word you can use to describe Jared Allen, Greg, is efficient. He doesn't waste his chances at the offensive end. I mean, like ever.
He's very smart with his shot selection. But don't let that take away from his defense. Allen takes a lot of pride in protecting the rim.
Ball's knocked loose. Stolen by Allen. Holiday surveying the floor. Middleton outside. There's the pass to Allen. Lock at six to the middle. Here's Holiday. Allen with the rebound. Looking at the last game for Milwaukee, it was a loss to the Raptors. Mobley, the pass to Garland. Allen trying to break free. No good that time. Good D by Holiday. Antetokounmpo kicks to Holiday. With the drive, the Cavaliers pull it in. Allen's got four rebounds now tonight. Stevens, the pass to Allen. Holiday against Garland. Allen dishes to Garland. This one for three. Allen's shot is off. Bucks trail by four. Allen kicks to Antetokounmpo. And in this first quarter, about 3 minutes played. And Greg, Giannis is such a handful on the offensive end. You know, teams have no choice but to foul.
And it is hard because Giannis knows how to create contact. And refs have started to give him the benefit of the doubt. he'll be getting double-digit free throw attempts for a long time.
And the first one drops.
You know, if we didn't quite grasp Antetokounmpo's potential coming into the league, it didn't take long to see that he is really a generational talent. I mean, he's blown us all away with his athleticism and skill set. And I would add to that his work ethic, too. You can tell he's really worked on his body and his game.
And both free throws good for Giannis. We're about 3 minutes into this first quarter. So timeout called here, the first for Cleveland. Let's check out the Eastern Conference standings now that we're in the new year. Taking a look at Milwaukee. The season well underway, and they've been solid in third right now. And checking out Cleveland, three games behind.
And right now for the Cavaliers, this hasn't been the breakout season that many were predicting, but they're still very much in the hunt for a high postseason seed, and that will keep them focused here during the season's final stages.
And they need to stay focused. I mean, they have to ensure they hang on to a high seed. It's imperative for them.
Holiday against Garland. Markkanen a screen on Holiday. Knocks it loose. Garland against Middleton. Just five to shoot. And that'll be Cleveland as it goes out of bounds. Cavaliers retain possession. We have got to see that sensational mobile one block again.
And an early swat like that can really set the tone. Now the shooters will be feeling his presence.
And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in the first quarter. The offensive rebound, Allen. And Allen slams it in.
Well, you see the hustle from Allen there, guys, and his relentlessness and the mindset to keep at it really allows him to gobble up those offensive boards.
And Middleton kicks to Antetokounmpo. Nobody near Allen. Yes, and it's Holiday with the assist that time.
And he's not going to miss that sort of an opportunity from deep.
Outside, Markkanen. Back to Garland. Six to shoot. Holiday with the block.
Well, we've always talked about the great defender that Holiday is. Well, he showed you right there with the rejection.
Got a hand on it. Stevens, the pass to Garland. High post, Allen. Back to Garland. Offline with his three. And so Giannis will bring it up for the Milwaukee Bucks. Outplayed in the previous game on their schedule, losing to the Raptors.
I'll tell you, they played hard, they drew fouls, but they could not convert at the line.
And that can drive guys absolutely crazy. I mean, they know they're better free throw shooters than that, but just did not get it done from the line.
Allen's shot is off.
And you don't want to give up that kind of look too often.
Here's Stephens, still looking for his first bucket in this one. Markkanen can't get it to go. Milwaukee's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Holiday against Garland. The Bucks working the ball around. The shot by Holiday, no good.
He is zero for his last however many this quarter, guys. Might need to get him out and let him settle down a bit here.
And the call will go against Grayson Allen. That is his first foul of the game. And it's a completely new group on the floor for the Cavaliers. Big group substitution here for Milwaukee. Wara checked in. Pat Connaughton comes in for Chris Middleton. Matthews, he's checked in for Grayson Allen. And George Hills subbed in for Drew Holiday. Here's Osman. He provides a good amount of offense for the team, averaging around 11.5 points a game. Six on the shot clock. Trying to end the drought. Doesn't get it to drop for him. Now the Bucks take it the other way. Last time they met was in Milwaukee.
Painful to watch, guys. You could see their frustrations mounting, unable to get into any kind of a rhythm whatsoever.
Yeah, they had no answer for them. They simply got outplayed and outworked.
Cavaliers leading. Passes it to Windler. Hill against Rondo. Pass to Windler. Let's the three fly. He's off on that one.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
For three, Hill. Good on the triple.
Really like the presence of mind from Hill, preparing himself to shoot prior to the pass getting to him.
119 left to play here in the first.
And after going undrafted way back in 2009, Wes Matthews still getting after it.
And Greg, you know, he overcame a torn Achilles tendon along the way. So it's a great example of finding your role and then filling it to a T.
Milwaukee's gone 2-5 from three-point land here in the first quarter. Antetokounmpo, a screen on Wade, fires the three, and another three for Milwaukee.
Yeah, this looks like a pregame shoot-around with all the threes they're allowing.
Rondo dishes to Love. Pass to Osman. He dishes it to Wade. And they wasted no time getting those 3 points back.
And an eye for an eye. Both teams working to stretch the floor.
Nothing like answering back. One team gets three, you fire three of your own. Boom.
Now here's Giannis. The shot's good.
And Antetokounmpo showing his versatility yet again. His dribble moves are virtually unguardable.
Here's Rondo. Tipped away. The pass to Antetokounmpo. From the arc. That one misses. And so the first quarter is in the books. Bucks lead by four. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from Rocket Mortgage Fieldhouse. And a valued reserve for the Bucks. Pat Connaughton was asked about the depth of this team.
I've been saying it for a long time. You know, we have much more depth than I think people realize. You know, I honestly think through the roster 1 to 15, you have guys that, you know, would be rotation players on any other team.
And he's a prime example. The former second-round pick continuing to improve.
Refining his perimeter shot, Kevin. And as we've seen, he can play above the rim as well.
And if you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter in this one. When you consider how the Bucks are doing, what do you guys think?
Just stretching out the floor that first. They had the defense scrambling.
And you know what? That's what happens when you establish your three-point game early. Puts the defense right up against it.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, as the second quarter gets going. On the court for Cleveland, Mobley and Allen, the two big men inside. Garland is out there with Rajon Rondo, and it's Wade in at the three spot.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw good from Allen. Well, here we are, Clark, at the midway point of the season. Lots of guys banged up. Is it hard to decide for a player when to play through an injury and when to sit?
Yeah, you know, so many factors to consider there, Kevin. I mean, is the injury going to get worse by you trying to play? Is it a matter of pain tolerance and you won't do any additional damage? So that's the delicate dance you're trying to figure out when you're considering playing while not being 100%. The biggest one to me is obviously, is it a long-term impact if you continue to play?
It's a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Jrue Holiday has been a welcome addition to this Bucks team. Chris Middleton said he just knows how to play the game on and off the ball. How to move without it, how to set guys up. He makes the game easier for everybody. He's made them a lot better, guys.
So you make us, David. Thank you. With stories like that. That kid, Jrue Holiday, he is a quality kid. Wonderful character, terrific play. And they're able to recover.
And that's evidence that Markkanen is working on his defense, and it's critical that he does so. And blocks like this show he's making good strides.
Middleton can't get it to go.
Not pretty. You've just got to shake off a miss like that.
Markkanen kicks to Garland. Markkanen passes to Rondo. Markkanen down low. Covered by Hood. Markkanen good.
You know, Rondo's highest priority is to get his teammates open shots every trip. I mean, that's what makes him go and endears him to his teammates.
Here's Holiday. He hits that shot, his first of the night, now 1 for 6. Garland with it. He's been patient so far, nothing on the scoreboard yet. And here in the second, 2 minutes gone by. Outside Rondo. Allen trying to break free. The shot by Rondo is no good. And so Hood will bring it up for Milwaukee. Portis sets the pick for Hood. Pass to Portis. Stolen by Markkanen. Allen outside. Back to Markkanen. And here's Rondo. Garland with a screen on Matthews. Rondo kicks to Markkanen. That doesn't go in. Had a chance, though, to take the lead. Matthews passes to Middleton. Portis sets the pick for Middleton. And Darius Garland picks up the foul. That's his first foul. And Cleveland making a change here. Stevens is checked in. Allen's checked in for the Bucks. Here in the second quarter, about 3 minutes played. Portis the screen. Holiday goes in. Shot clock at six. Hood finds Portis. Good! Portis has got his first points of the night.
Watch out now. When this guy gets into a rhythm, it is something to behold.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
Here's Steffens, defended by Allen. Steffens can't get it to go. Bucks leading by four. Pass to Holiday. Portis a screen on Garland. Here's Holiday. Gets in and hoping this is the start of a new trend. 2 for 8 now from the field.
Boy, such good instincts and agility. Makes Holiday really dangerous on the offensive glass. That time he fought to keep the play alive and got the bucket.
Mobley with it, and Holiday picks him up defensively. Trying to get something going. Mobley misses. Milwaukee has gone 3 of 7 tonight from three-point territory. Portis, the pass to Holiday. Bucks passing it around. Here's Middleton. Garland with the rebound. The Cavaliers trail by six.
Boy, you talk about 3-and-D guys. Middleton is the epitome of that player. Great range, mid-range game, can defend multiple positions. He does all of that at an elite level.
And they'll get another chance. Second shot opportunity. No good there. Great D that time from Hood. Milwaukee leading by six. You know, Clark, many view Middleton as the prototypical perimeter point.
I would not disagree at all. He does everything and does it all well.
Now here's Allen. They lead by six, their biggest margin. Poked away. Holiday finds Middleton. No luck, they battled on the glass but couldn't knock it down. Garland against Holiday. Garland attacking. And it's off the back rim. No good.
And the well is running dry for him right now. Nothing falling.
And, you know, you can sense his frustration. This is going to be a test of his resolve here.
Stevens, the pass to Garland. They could use a bucket. Misses the layup. He had him with that pump fake.
Oof, this has been brutal. I mean, he still hasn't made a single shot. No wonder they're struggling.
Holiday dishes to Hood. Pass to Portis. Middleton outside. Hits the three-point bomb. Middleton's got the lead up to 9 now for the Bucks.
Boy, when you've got the jump shot that Chris Middleton has, you're always a weapon, which means you help create spacing for your teammates.
Some high-scoring teams in the NBA. Let's see the leaders. In fourth, the Bucks.
And how about the year they've had offensively? This is a team that can put points on the board in a hurry. Always fun to watch them play.
The Cavaliers trail by 9. Windler, the pass to Allen. Here's Osman. He's still scoreless so far in this one.
Hey, when Giannis is lurking nearby, you got to be careful because his wingspan can erase a lot of shots.
Connaughton passes to Norum and stolen by Love. Here's Windler. .129 left to play here in the second quarter. Stephens, good.
Obviously, a mix-up defensively on that possession.
Antetokounmpo passes to Connaughton. Back to Giannis. Cavaliers with the rebound.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
The pass to Osman. Allen with it. Inside. Here's Love. Mora grabs the board. And so he'll bring it up for the Milwaukee Bucks. Now the feed to Giannis. Hill looking it over. Giannis sets a screen for Hill. And it's sent back by Allen.
Boy, that expansive reach of Allen. I mean, so good at positioning himself and using his length and timing to stifle shooters.
Here's Stephens. He can't get that one to fall. Excellent D there from Allen.
No doubt he's struggling right now from the field. Let's see if he can get it going this quarter.
Sinks the triple.
And this really is the story of the game. They've been outstanding from beyond the arc, especially in the second quarter.
Passes it to Windler. Trying to answer back, but that three is off the mark. And so it's Milwaukee looking at a 13-point lead heading into the next quarter. And it's been their rugged defense setting the tone. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much, Mike. Stout effort defensively in the first half. What did you do to limit them?
I just think our activity on the ball, we got to try and keep it in front of us. Our bigs did a good job, I think, being big in the paint, making things tough there. We got to finish it with the board.
Yep, rebounds and possessions, Coach. Thanks. Back to you guys.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
Greetings, Shaq, Kenny, and EJ here as we tip off the show with a look at our midseason Eastern Conference standings. And taking a look at the bottom of the standings.
Well, you know what? I like to say that those teams are simply in transition.
Kenny, you're always so positive. That's why we love you on this show.
Thank you, Shaq. I love you too.
I love you more.
I think you're both okay. In transition. All right, fellas, let's check in on our first half of action and the dominating performance for the Bucks.
They were getting after it on the glass, like wild animals. They've got a nice edge in that department, which has led to this lead. They won the heart and hustle battle in that first half. Now we'll see if they can keep that going.
And that concludes halftime. Now time to send it over to Kevin Harlan as the game's about to resume.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. You look at George Hill, he's really been playing well.
And, you know, not always the guy that you would expect to be making the big plays, but so far tonight, he has delivered.
Yeah, he has, and he's really been a difference maker so far, and it wouldn't surprise me if they look his way a bit more to end this game.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. On the court for the Bucks, Giannis and Portis, the lengthy post pair for him. Holiday out there with Allen, and it's Middleton in at the small forward position. And Markkanen out of Finland, Greg, was one of the hot names in free agency this last summer.
And surprisingly, didn't get an extension before the season. Just hard to find seven-footers that can shoot like Markkanen. You knew at least a few teams would try and lure him away.
That free throw good for Markkanen. And a lot of players want a voice in team strategy. And I've always wondered, Greg, is there a downside for coaches letting their players get too involved?
I mean, there is a belief that you can have too many cooks in the kitchen, right? But if a player knows his stuff, it's worth at least hearing them out, if only to keep those open lines of communication.
From the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. After making the finals four straight years from 2015 to 2018, there have been some lean years lately for the Cavaliers. Over the last three seasons, they've only won a couple more games than they did in a single season, their title season of 2016. Coach J.B. Bickerstaff says the losing is tough on everybody, but I look forward to the journey ahead. Kevin, back to you.
What do they say, D.A.? The journey is the reward. Thanks. Mobley misses.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
And what I like about it, it's been a physical brand of basketball. It's had a little sandpaper element to it. Gritty and rough, but that's how you win games.
Here's Stephens following the three by Milwaukee. Allen, a screen on Allen. Stevens, the pass to Garland. Here's Mobley. And it's off from three-point range. Here's Giannis. Down low, takes the 13-footer, and it goes down 2 points. And the Bucks lead by 17.
Improving as a playmaker, Giannis knows this is the next step in him becoming an even greater player.
Here's Stephens, defended by Allen. Stephens, the pass to Mobley. Holiday against Garland. Five to shoot. Over Holiday, the Cavaliers again can't hit. Bucks leading by 17. Now here's Middleton. That shot off.
You know, it's really surprising that they're up at this point, given that he struggled so mightily.
Pass to Markkanen. To the middle. Here's Allen, and it's Allen slamming it down.
How about that? Throwing it down. Allen oozes energy, and teammates feed off of
him. A touch over 2.5 minutes of basketball played here in the third quarter. To the left wing. Pass to Allen. Now here's Adetokunbo. Allen with the screen for Giannis. And another three for Milwaukee.
And the execution has just been off defensively here in the second. Play after play, it's almost as if they're a step slow.
Matthews, he's checked in for the Bucks. While we're in the quick break, let's show you the list of the hottest shooting rookies in the NBA this year. Number one, Evan Mobley.
And the numbers say it all. I mean, he's tremendously efficient at scoring the basketball around the rim. He's almost automatic.
Yeah, excellent footwork he has. I mean, terrific in his shot selection for such a young player. He's dependable, coachable, steady. This kid's going to really go far.
Second half of play, and we're 3 minutes into the third here. Wade kicks to Rondo. To the paint. Markkanen down low. Defended by Middleton, and it's good for two.
Impressive awareness from Markkanen. I mean, down on the block there, really good job of using his height to get his shots off.
Milwaukee leading by 16. Portis the screen. Matthews finds Antetokounmpo, and Matthews gets it to go in on the assist by Giannis. Giannis has got four assists in the game. And the pass to Rondo. There's a good screen to the inside. Here's Mobley, and it's blocked.
Get the perimeter.
Matthews against Rondo. Now here is Holiday. D right on him, and the officials call him for a three-second violation. A moment now to see how the schedule is looking for Milwaukee. On Friday, they'll be playing against LaMarcus Aldridge and the Brooklyn Nets. Then on Saturday, they'll be matching up against Gordon Hayward and the Charlotte Hornets.
And you know for that matchup with Charlotte, this is a game that they are expected to win, but sometimes those are the kind of games where you get a little bit sloppy and start looking ahead. Either way, they'll need to put in tremendous effort to walk away with a victory.
A drive by Garland. Out to Wade. Five on the clock. Mobley the pass to Rondo. Lets it go from deep. The rebound by the Bucks. Middleton's got four rebounds in this game. Portis a screen on Markkanen. Middleton right side. Garland against Matthews. Over Garland. No good on the shot. A bit long that time. The Cavaliers trail by 19.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Pass to Mobley. Back to Garland. Cleveland needs to get a shot off here. Wade finds Garland. And another miss by Cleveland.
You know, I wouldn't be surprised if he gets yanked soon. I mean, that's how bad his shot selection has been.
Now Holiday. His numbers are looking pretty good. He's got his scoring average up around 18.5 points a game.
And it's rare to find a young big man with such an advanced skill set. Mobley can handle the ball like a small forward, has a smooth shot and great range.
Now here's Garland. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Wade dishes to Rondo. Back to Wade. Can they get it? Once again off the mark by Cleveland. And as much as Mobley helps you out on the offensive end, Greg, he can get you stops as well.
Yeah, I mean, he's got great instincts with quick reflexes. Can slide his feet on the perimeter and has great timing as a shot blocker. I mean, what else do you need?
Garland, no good.
He's been an absolute non-factor. Zero factor this game. Just a horrible performance from him.
Giannis dunks it down.
How about the springs of this guy, Antetokounmpo, also known as the Greek Freak? I mean, he just gets up off the ground like a rocket on these alley-oop chances.
Now, here's Mobley. And you can see his scoring totals. Those are some pretty good numbers. He's putting up close to 15 points a game on average. Holiday against Rondo. Over Holiday. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
Guys, that's putting it mildly. I mean, they've been absolutely dominant.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Really a prime example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
Now here's Rondo. Over Holiday. Stolen by Holiday. To the paint. Here's Matthews. It's rebounded by Cleveland.
I still can't believe that one didn't fall.
Inside. It's stolen by Antetokounmpo. It's tipped. There's 25 seconds left in the third quarter of the game, and Darius Garland picks up the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game.
Oh, great defense there. Anticipated the play and got there first.
And not afraid to put his body on the line either. He took a shot for the team in that situation.
Here's what Milwaukee's going with right now. Wara checked in, and it's Pat Connaughton in for Chris Middleton. Hill against Rondo. Hill with it. Pass to Antetokounmpo. The kick out to Hill. Three-pointer. And that one released in time, but no good. And so it's Milwaukee, finishing the quarter up by a whopping 24 points. The three-point shooting has come fast and furious to the tune of what has become a big-time blowout in progress. Right back after this break. And while we can now, let's take a look at today's State Farm assist of the game.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feed.
For me, next to the big-time alley-oops and monster throwdowns, passes like that are probably the next best thing when it comes to sweet-looking NBA highlights.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. We've got Kevin Love, and it's Osman in at the small forward. That's the five for Cleveland right now. Nwora, the pass to Connaughton. Screen by Antetokounmpo. Four on the shot clock. Good on the bucket. Connaughton's got the fourth quarter started here with a bucket for the Bucks.
And the lack of effort to fight over the screen there makes that an easy shot.
Well, I'm going to credit the screen. I mean, that's a good, strong pick he lays there.
Now here's Rondo. And the rejection by Giannis. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Antetokounmpo. Luke Kornet, he's checked in for the Bucks. Hood comes in for Pat Connaughton. Puts it up, off the inbound. Good, he hits the jump shot.
And you could tell they had that play ready to go. Well done on the inbound.
And so he'll bring it up for the Bucks. Kicks to Allen. It's back to Hill. Amazing how many players we're seeing come into the NBA, Clark, from all over the world right now.
Well, it's truly a global game, Kevin, and give credit to former Commissioner David Stern and certainly Adam Silver and his staff. But the league is a global league. The star players have done a great job of promoting it as a worldwide game as well. Every year, you get players from multiple continents, Asia, Africa, Europe, Australia. Basketball is, again, it's a global game, so it makes sense we'll see more players from all over the world in the NBA.
And what do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for the Bucks?
You know, one of the big stories has been the three ball. It's been a key part of their offense throughout the game.
And you've always heard of guys being in a zone shooting, but you can be in a zone passing the basketball, and we've seen that tonight as well.
Two shots. Relax on the first.
And that one misses. Jared Allen's checked in for Kevin Love. The Bucks also changing it up. Portis, he's checked in for Luke Kornet. Chris Middleton comes in for Hood. And it's Holiday in for George Hill. And he sinks the second. Final quarter here, and we're just over a minute and a half through it. It's Allen on the wing. Defended by Allen. Middleton outside. Outside Holiday. Down to five on the shot clock. Pass to Portis. The tray. Wow, drew the contact, and that three almost went in. So he'll go to the line for three free throws. It goes on Ed Davis. And last season, All-Stars Greg missing 19% of their available games. With the shortened off seasons, are you concerned about the toll it takes?
You are, but this offseason maybe as painfully short as the last one. And in these tough times, some sacrifices are made, no doubt. Health, perhaps, one of the biggest.
That free throw, no good. And Cleveland making a change here. And he's good on the second. And he nails the third. And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter now. And here is Mobley.
I mean, that's a tough break for the D. I mean, he took the hit and drew the whistle.
Yeah, but he was late to get there, so the referee couldn't give him a free pass on that one.
Goodwin's checked in for Cleveland and then for Milwaukee. Antetokounmpo comes in for Portis, and Smart subbed in for Drew Holiday. Over to the left wing. Here's Osman. Antetokounmpo defending. Lock at six. Goodwin. Here's Allen. Open and close and nails it. And he's now got the double-double. 10 points and 10 rebounds.
Boy, I love the mindset of Allen there. I mean, when he gets the ball in that spot, he's very aggressive.
Outside, Antetokounmpo. The three. It's hauled in by Goodwin.
And, you know, the defense to me looked like they were okay to let him prove he could make that shot.
Yeah, just solid work on the back end of that play.
Yep, you're right. Finished hard with two hands on that stuff.
Yeah, highly efficient. Nothing extra special there. Just effective.
Milwaukee leading by 21. Outside, Smart. And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. And it's sent back by Allen. An even three-on-three break. Fires the three. Milwaukee with the rebound. Smart finds Middleton. And Greg, with recent legal results, more opportunities now for compensation for college athletes. Do you like it?
I do. I mean, there's enough money going around. I don't have a problem with the athletes getting a share, especially with the amount of time and effort and energy they have to commit. Let's take care of the guys. Let them enjoy the collegiate experience.
Windler's shot is off.
Hard to figure out how he doesn't knock that one down. No defender in sight.
Allen's shot is off.
And, you know, even though they're on top, they're winning. I mean, they could use more from him. Trying to shut the door on this one.
Windler, the pass to Mobley. Goodwin with it. And to the Kumbos there. And it's Goodwin missing. And so it's Smart. He'll bring up the ball for the Milwaukee Bucks. They've allowed just 7 points here in the fourth quarter. And he gets the bucket.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Boy, the defense looks shell-shocked. I mean, they're on the ropes right now, on their heels.
And so here's Cleveland after the basket by Milwaukee. Allen kicks to Osman. First free throw is good. Well, Greg, for those of us who have never played in the league, what's it like traveling all over the country over the course of a long regular season?
Come on, Kevin. I bet you had a nice J back in the day. But seriously, it's a whirlwind tour, man. Sometimes you don't even know what city you wake up in. And I can tell you, there have been many times where I've gone back to the front desk complaining because my key didn't work, and only to find out I was using the wrong key.
He hits both from the stripe.
Yeah, I like that they haven't lost their aggressiveness here in the second, despite being down.
That's exactly when you need to be aggressive. You know that. I mean, another good job, though, of drawing contact and getting to the free throw line.
And here are the Cavaliers now, following Drew Holiday's three-point attempt. Now the pass to Rondo.
Cross the screen.
Giannis against Allen. Five to shoot. Here's Stephens. Count it. Good. Here's Holiday. There's the lob. Antetokounmpo takes the alley-oop pass and dunks it down.
Terrific find that time by Holiday. You get open. Drew will get it to you.
The Cavaliers trail by 21. Timeout called. Cleveland.
Kevin, I don't think we can overstate how big a deal it was for Holiday to come to the Bucks. I mean, this team went after him hard, and you can see why. He's such a terrific all-around player and a great leader as well.
And now, let's take a look at the New Balance player of the game, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
And his shooting percentage reflects just how efficient he's been. It's better than 50%, always a sign of a solid offensive performance. But his movement and his shot selection have also both been tremendous.
They lost two straight coming into this one, and he knew he needed to put his foot down. He's shown leadership tonight, getting them back on the winning track. Bucks on defense. Rondo looking over the floor. Markkanen sets the pick for Rondo. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
And Holiday was a hot name when he went on the trading block. Bucks paid the big price to get him.
And I think trading for him helped secure Giannis long-term, quite honestly. He really does complement this roster.
And Clark, you played in a very physical era. What do you think about the way fouls are called right now?
I really don't have a problem with it, Kevin. I mean, some of the fouls that were allowed in years past, way back in the 70s and 80s, I mean, those were borderline flagrant three kind of fouls. The game was more physical and it was accepted as such, but I don't know if that was necessarily good for the game. I think now the way they have it set up and the way it's officiated as it relates to physicality and flagrant fouls, yeah, it may be a little bit too far the other way, but I think it's the right balance overall.
And the second free throw, good.
You know, I still think Rondo is a great role player in the league. He knows he's out there to distribute the ball and provide leadership on the floor, and he does both really well.
Now here's Middleton. On the wing, Holiday. Antetokounmpo looking it over. Just five to shoot. Allen with the rebound. Allen's got the glass covered here tonight. 11 boards for him. Rondo against Holiday. Markkanen a screen on Holiday. Rondo passes to Markkanen. To the middle. Outside for Rondo. Good D by Holiday. Out of bounds, Cleveland takes possession. Both teams will make substitutions. The Cavaliers trail by 20. Outside Rondo. Passes to Osman. Cleveland moving the ball around. Here's Stevens. That one, no good. Great D that time from Portis.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for the Bucks.
As one-sided as it gets today, you know, there were some dominant moments in about every facet of this game for that team.
Yeah, I mean, Kevin, it's hard to think of what didn't go right for them. Game planning by the coaches, execution by the players, everything was just on target.
And so all the hard work here tonight converted into a tally in the win column. It'll be number 26 on the year. And we watched him all night long. No one could really stop him. Just another excellent game it was for Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Well, you have to marvel at how well he picked apart that defense repeatedly, found the right guy in the right spot at the right time.
The Cavaliers making a switch here. Windler's checked in. Giannis passes to Matthews. And here's Hood. Wants to get it to Antetokounmpo and does. Good D by Wade. About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Going inside. Outside for Rondo. Tries yet again. And they had their chances. Two offensive rebounds, but they still come up empty. Outside, Antetokounmpo. And so it's the Bucks taking care of business in this one. To come into an opponent's building and dominate the way they did tonight says, I think, Greg, an awful lot about this team.
I guess they don't need home cooking to feel at home. I mean, Kevin, just a masterful performance all the way around.
And we've got David Aldridge standing by on our sideline with the player of the game. David, it's all yours.
Thanks very much. Giannis, a dominant performance. What is the level that this team is playing at?
It's amazing, man. I think the whole group, the whole team played hard. The whole team was ready. Everybody stepped up. And, you know, this is what makes an average team from a great team or a good team.
I know you guys are looking for great and not good. Congrats on the win. Back to you guys.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for being with us. So long and good night, everyone.